Right, how many of you like a parade? Do you like parades? Saw you in the marketplace this morning buying pomegranates. Good. Parades are just so much fun. There's so much going on. There's always a lot of happy people. Look at all the happy people that came to this parade this morning. Here we are coming to Jerusalem to see Jesus. Now, when Jesus came to Jerusalem, you know, he came to have a party. He came to celebrate. He came to celebrate the Jewish festival of the Passover. It was a party to remember the night that the angel of death passed over the houses of the Israelites when they were in Egypt. It was a party to celebrate that Moses once led those Israelites out of slavery and into freedom. So that night in Jerusalem, Jesus gathered together with his friends for the Passover. He gathered them all together because he wanted to tell them how much he loved each and every one of them, and he wanted one last opportunity to celebrate and to dine with them. Before he died, Lord Jesus took some friends aside. Then he told them he would have to go away. As they sat around the table, ready, willing, strong, and able, Jesus broke the bread and then was heard to say, had dined, Lord Jesus poured a cup of wine, giving thanks, he shared the peace, and then, well, he said he'd have to die, and when they asked him why, Jesus passed the cup and told them once again,
come and die.
Well, they were having a good celebration that night with lots of good food, I gotta believe. Some good pomegranates from the market that Ella bought, and some lamb, and who knows what else. But then in the middle of this joyous, happy celebration, Jesus made a very surprising announcement. He stopped them from eating and from drinking to tell them that one of the men in that room was going to deceive him or betray him. This person was going to hand Jesus over to his enemies. And at that point, the room became very somber. And everyone wondered who that betrayer was going to be. Questions had been asked about who would turn Jesus over to his enemies, he finally announced that it was going to be his friend and his fellow disciple, Judas. Now everyone at the celebration was surprised, and maybe some of them were even mad that it had to happen. But someone had to be sure that God's plan was carried out. And Jesus knew that in order for this to happen, he would have to be given over to the hands of the Roman authorities. It was hard for people to continue to eat their food. You can imagine how difficult that was. And then, as they were all gathered, kind of shocked, stumbling, wondering what was happening around the table, Jesus surprised them by taking some bread. And he raised the bread, and he blessed it, and he broke it. And then he gave it to them, and he said, "This is my body, and I'm going to give it to you. And whenever you eat of this bread, remember that I forgive you, and I am with you." And then when they got done eating that night, he took a cup. And he went to them, and he said, this cup is my blood. It's the new covenant in my blood, and it's shed for you, and you, and you, and you, and you, and you, and all of you. And whenever you drink of this cup, remember that your sins are forgiven, and I am with you always.
Oh.
even 2,000 years after that night, Jesus still comes to us in that same bread and that same wine, right here in this room in Madison, Wisconsin.